Are you sitting comfortably?
Good.
Then we'll begin.
Since the dawn of humanity, stories have been an intrinsic part of our culture. The influence of storytelling can be seen in every aspect of our lives, from the glamour and glitz of Hollywood to the dusty tarmac of the school playground. Stories define our values, desires and dreams, as well as our beliefs, fears and prejudices. Today, we are here to tell you about the incredible story of Roffa, the bear who defied gravity, and his remarkable space adventure, powered by the pupils of King's Rochester.
It all started in September 2016 with an email from our principal proposing the idea. Immediately, this seemed like the perfect chance for the digital genius team at our school. Operation Cosmic Dust was born. As the term blasted towards Christmas, naturally, the weather deteriorated. Therefore, our wonderful cluster of digital geniuses spent the rest of the Michaelmas term capturing the required equipment. The balloon itself, the cords, the payload, and a GoPro camera.
All of which were purchased to accompany our very own astronaut in training, Captain Roffa, on the seminal, the extraordinary Operation Cosmic Dust.
Also accompanying Captain Roffa on his journey was his very own Twitter account and blog, both of which provided progress reports, plans, student work, and information about how the project was developing.
One example of a blog of stellar storytelling, inspired by Roffa's journey, is this wonderful iMovie produced by digital genius Joseph Terry on his iPad. It tells the story of space travel and represents the learning that engaging projects can inspire.
Space was the V-2 missile, which was used in World War II. In October 14, 1947, American test pilot Chuck Yeager breaks the sound barrier for the first time in the X-1, also known as Glamorous Glennis. In 1957, Russia launched a modified R-7 two-stage ICBM with the satellite Sputnik 1 aboard. Sputnik 1 was the first artificial satellite. The space race between the Soviet Union and the United States began now. In April 12, 1961, this man became the first human in space.
Cool. My name is Felix Gerber, and on April 12, 1961, I became the first man in space. It took a 108-minute flight on Vostok 1, in which I completed one orbit of the Earth. And I made the first spacewalk in March 18, 1965. This is the Vostok orbiter. This is the shuttle that took Alexei Leonov into space so he could make his spacewalk.
4 years after Alexei Leonov's famous first spacewalk, the Americans put a man on the moon, fulfilling JFK's speech of getting man to the moon by the end of the decade. In April 19, 1971, a proton rocket launched the first space station, Soyuz 1. April 12, 1981, Space Shuttle Columbia lifts off from Cape Canaveral, beginning the first space mission for NASA's new astronaut transportation system. On January 28, 1986, Challenger explodes 73 seconds after launch, grounding the shuttle fleet for more than 2 years. 4 years after Challenger exploded, the Space Shuttle Discovery releases the Hubble telescope into Earth's orbit. In February 1st, 2003, the Space Shuttle Columbia disintegrates as it re-enters the Earth's atmosphere, killing the crew. Last time, ending the space shuttle program. Man has been to space and has traveled to the moon, all because of the use of space flight. Where will space flight take man next?
One of the many important jobs carried out by the Digital Genius team was designing the payload. It needed to carry a GoPro camera with an additional battery pack, two SMS transmitters, and of course, Roffa himself, positioned to be in clear view of the GoPro.
Once selected, the winning team went to work after school with the DD department to put the payload together. Footage was also captured by iPad and digital genius Max 9 used Final Cut Pro to tell the story of the payload's construction. Despite what it looks like, we promise you, Roffa did not suffer.
On 4 Unfortunately, we were unable to convince the headmaster to let us drive to Calais to collect one. Or borrow one of the school rowing boats to fish him out of the North Sea. So we simply had to wait. And wait. And wait. And wait. Until, at last, after months and months of planning and hard work, the Digital Genius team noticed an imminent change of wind direction. It finally looked like we had a launch date.
Immediately, the excitement began to build. The metaphorical planets had aligned and the official countdown to Operation Cosmic Dust had begun. Launch date was to be Thursday the 25th of May 2017, and what a day it was.
Major Tom to ground control. I'm stepping.
Also, it's a national and international news. But more importantly, Roffa disembarked into the imagination of our pupils. And in their English lessons, inspired them to create vibrant display of diverse responses to Roffa's iconic space adventure. The work produced varied from diaries and newspaper writing to poetry, and the following two examples, I think, capture memorably our pupils' engagement with the story of this very ordinary bear who became a VIB, a very important bear.
Up I go. Bear traveller.
Stargazer.
World seeker.
Dream chaser.
Balloon hanger.
Space catcher.
Sky leaper.
Sound speaker.
Oxygen grabber.
Shine beamer.
Global viewer.
Crash lander.
VIP campaigner.
I am the bear traveller.
He hasn't got breathing apparatus on, so they couldn't send him right into space because he hasn't got a spacesuit on. You know, he's just a teddy in a t-shirt. But he did go 100,000 feet up, which is like 20 miles into the stratosphere.
Whoa.
And then the balloon popped. Oh no! Don't worry. Get a parachute. AK parachuting down. There was a couple out in their garden, just enjoying the evening. It wasn't alien invasion, they went and checked him out and they found him with a little note on him saying, can you ring the school if you find me? And he made it to Tunbridge, so he had a lovely adventure. You can follow him on Twitter, Roffa, R-O-F-F-A, the bear, Roffa the bear on Twitter, and they're downloading the video because he took a GoPro camera with him as well.
Teddy bear ever.
Isn't it? I think the coolest school ever as well.
Oh my gosh.
Well done everyone at the prep school, and well done Roffa. He's back and he's safe everybody. We'll get the links up, KMFM official on our Facebook. What about that? Space bear.